Bonjour à tous. Good morning, everyone. I'm happy to be joined today by Minister Leblanc, as well as by Dr. Tam and Dr. New. La campagne de vaccination de masse se poursuit. Chaque jour, on travaille sans relâche pour avoir le plus de doses possible, le plus rapidement possible. Vendredi passé, on a annoncé que des millions de doses du vaccin de Pfizer vont arriver plus tôt que prévu, dont 1,5 million de doses avant la fin mars. Suite à cette nouvelle, on augmente donc notre total de vaccins reçus contre la COVID-19 avant la fin mars à 8 millions de doses. Je sais que ça fait beaucoup de chiffres et de calculs, mais l'important, c'est ceci. La vaccination s'accélère de façon significative. Il y a de plus en plus de gens qui reçoivent leur vaccin, incluant beaucoup de parents et de grands-parents que vous avez hâte de revoir. Et les travailleurs de première ligne, et chaque jour, il y a de plus en plus de gens qui sont protégés. Right now, across the country, we're getting vaccines to Canadians. We now have 4 vaccines approved by independent regulators in Canada, more than any other country. Again, you can count on the fact that any vaccine approved in Canada is both safe and effective. Last week, we received almost 1 million doses of COVID-19 vaccines. This week, we're getting another 1 million. And before the end of this month, we will have received a total of 8 million doses of COVID-19 vaccines. On the 500,000 AstraZeneca vaccine doses delivered from the Serum Institute last week, these shots are being distributed to provinces as we speak. More and more people are getting vaccinated every day. That means more grandparents, healthcare workers, and vulnerable people are now safer. Our top priority is to get you your shot as soon as possible. No one will be left behind. Just take Myrtle from Kahnawake, Quebec. She's 90 years old and was the first elderly person living at home in Kahnawake to receive a vaccine. For Myrtle and her family, getting her shot was a big moment because now she'll be able to tell her sons who call every Sunday that she is safer. La dernière année n'a pas été facile, mais malgré tout, c'est important de se rappeler qu'on a des raisons de rester positif. Par exemple, hier, c'était la Journée internationale des femmes. C'était le moment de s'arrêter pour célébrer les réalisations des femmes dans toute leur diversité, ici au Canada et ailleurs dans le monde. Malheureusement, c'était aussi le moment de se rappeler que les conséquences de la pandémie ont été plus prononcées pour les femmes et les filles. On ne peut pas laisser cette crise faire reculer tous les progrès sociaux et économiques acquis par les femmes depuis tant d'années. Pour rebâtir en mieux, il faut que la relance économique puisse profiter à tout le monde. Yesterday, Deputy Prime Minister Freeland announced the creation of the Task Force on Women in the Economy. This 18-member task force, from CEOs and childcare advocates to labor representatives, economists, and Indigenous leaders, will advise the government on continuing to advance gender equality in the wake of the pandemic. We need to rebuild an economy that's fair for everyone. So that's exactly what we're going to do. Of course, this is just one part of the equation. After all, it's almost impossible to get, let alone keep, a good job without a roof over your head. Everyone deserves a safe and affordable place to call home. Yesterday, the federal government partnered with the government of British Columbia to announce a $517 million housing benefit investment over 10 years. This is part of our $2 billion commitment to the Canada Housing Benefit to support families right across the country. For more than 25,000 households in BC, the new Canada-British Columbia Housing Benefit will provide financial assistance to marginalized people with low incomes to help with monthly rent. On average, this could mean around $400 in support each month in rent. This program is designed to get right to people who need it most. That's why the benefit will go directly to households through non-profit housing providers or through BC Housing. Investments like this are real steps forward to make sure that everyone has a safe place to call home. I want to thank Ministers Ahmed Hussein and Joyce Murray, Member of Parliament Terry Beach, and their counterparts in BC for all their important work on this issue. Jeudi cette semaine, le 11 mars, ça va faire un an que la COVID-19 a été officiellement déclarée une pandémie mondiale par l'OMS. En peu de temps, nos vies ont changé. Ce qui paraissait normal la veille allait le devenir de moins en moins au cours des semaines et des mois qui allaient suivre. Cette semaine, on marque un mois que vous faites des sacrifices. À tous les Canadiens qui font des efforts, petits et grands, je veux vous dire merci. Je sais que ce n'est pas facile. C'est le genre de crise qui arrive seulement une fois par siècle. On va s'en sortir en étant unis et en continuant de travailler ensemble. On fait du chemin depuis l'année dernière et il en reste beaucoup à faire, mais on va finir par vaincre la COVID-19. We're naming March 11th, 2021, as a National Day of Observance to honor everyone we lost to this terrible virus and to recognize the impact this global pandemic has had on all our lives. Around the world, more than 2.5 million people have died because of COVID-19. 22,000 of them were our fellow Canadians. They have been taken from us, but they will not be forgotten. Each one was special. Each one was loved. They were grandparents, friends, parents, brothers, sisters, and colleagues. There are no words for the pain of losing someone you love. As a country, we remember all those we lost and we mourn with families and friends. To everyone who is grieving, we're thinking of you and we're there for you. On Thursday, I invite all Canadians to join together to honor the memory of those we have lost and to thank all those who continue to make incredible sacrifices to fight this pandemic. Together, we will beat this virus.